Our first story kicks off the start of our Limitless campaign, where Fairgo puts the rights of New Zealand's disabled community in the spotlight.
Rights like buying tickets to a sports game or a concert at the same price, with the same ease as an able-bodied person. That's a given, right? Well, sadly, not yet. Here's Caitlin.
Up here, Jack has the best seat in the house.
So I just feel free, just a totally different feeling.
Far from what he faces back on the ground.
Good land.
Where booking and getting to events is often more trouble than it's worth.
Up against a whole lot of different situations with venues and also promoters and ticket sellers.
All because Jack uses a wheelchair. But it doesn't need to be this way.
It's not special treatment. It's literally just being able to interact and engage in society like everybody else does.
What we want really is just a fair go.
It starts from the moment tickets go on sale, which many fans snap up online. Most accessible tickets, though, can only be purchased over the phone.
Booking tickets to events is a complete nightmare. You ring the specialist accessible line, and then you're generally on hold for a minimum, I would say, of at least 45 minutes, sometimes longer.
3 hours longer to talk to someone at Ticketmaster.
It said the ticket office was open 9 till 9. So I rang at 4:36 to get some tickets, and I waited, and I listened to the music.
Your call has progressed in the queue.
Only no one was at the other end. While in Ōtautahi Christchurch, Jack was hanging on the line to Ticketek.
I had to wait an hour and a half.
He wasn't going to miss out on seeing the Tall Blacks in action.
My godson, Ethan Rusbatch, was playing on the team.
But after spending his time, Jack was told he'd need to spend more dollars, 3 times as much for an accessible space.
I asked him, what about the $20 tickets? And he says, they're not for wheelchairs. For general admission. And I said, this is wrong.
Ticketek doesn't set prices, the event holder does. So we threw the matter into Basketball New Zealand's court.
We completely agree that accessible seating prices at any sporting event should not cost 3 times the amount of a general admission ticket. That is unacceptable. The prices for this Tall Blacks game were determined by the area that the seats were located in. In this case, in a premium section of the arena. We recognise now that this was an error on our part. TVNZ will commit to improving the price point for all accessible seating prices at our national team sporting events in the future. And we thank Fairgo for helping to shine a light on this issue for us and for others.
And in a score for Jack,
Basketball NZ wants to give you a free ticket to its next event.
Oh, cool. Thank you. I really appreciate it. I feel really good about it.
So now it's back to Sally, who moves from lengthy phone calls to being separated in seating plans.
You have a son,
yes.
And a husband.
Yes.
But you can't all sit together.
No, because most venues allow you an accessible seat and a companion seat. So one of us always has to sit on our own.
Like at the rugby, where she's been on one side of the stadium, her friends on the other.
So it's not very easy to get a beer at halftime with them or move around, or it limits the experience you can have.
It was hoped new legislation introduced to Parliament last year would remove access barriers for Kiwis.
So the Accessibility for New Zealanders Bill is really an attempt to catch us up with much of the rest of the world when it comes to accessibility.
The US and Australia have had laws in place for 30 years, ensuring equality for people with disabilities in many areas of life, including events.
Been to a baseball game in San Francisco. They just removed a chair from the back row and I was able to sit in the middle of my husband and son, which was great.
Or take the upcoming musical Hamilton, for example. Showing in Auckland, it can host up to 4,255 guests each night. 24 of those seats are accessible ones, which are found in 2 parts of the arena. But under Australian law, there would need to be double that, 50 seats in a variety of places. In the US, it'd be 31 seats, and those purchasing an accessible ticket can also buy up to 3 additional seats for their companions in the same row.
You can see straight away that that is a huge difference in terms of the disabled person or in terms of a wheelchair user being able to attend a show.
Spark Arena says it ensures accessible seating is located in areas with an optimal view, as well as having good access to fire exits. People can choose between 3 price points, and when accessible seats sell out, the venue says it tries to accommodate guests in other areas that provide a similar experience. As for our own standards here in Aotearoa, advocates say the current ones before Parliament are toothless.
Accessibility legislation needs to have some form of regulatory mechanism and reporting structure so that if something isn't accessible, there's a place you can report it, there's a mechanism in place where someone can come out and have a look and check it out, and if it's not meeting those accessibility standards, then there's a consequence.
Until that happens, Fair Go's calling on the events industry to put accessibility centre stage, including ticket sales.
The ideal situation is that if we could just book directly online.
Ticketmaster already has its website set up for this, but not all events are using the service. The options there at Eden Park for Pink's upcoming concert and the FIFA Women's World Cup. Spark Arena's another venue committing to more online ticketing in the future. As for those still stuck on the phone, Ticketmaster says it gets swamped when major events go on sale and recent bad weather affected its contact centre operations. When it comes to seating alongside whānau and friends, a spokesperson for Eden Park told us it has a number of accessible seating areas dotted throughout the venue to give people choice in where they sit. It's just built specially designed accessible spaces, which will include better sight lines, heating and TV screens. When it comes to accommodating groups, the venue says because it stands as sloped, access to seating areas that are not dedicated wheelchair spaces can be tricky because of the need to use stairs. Spark Arena says it offers limited seating for a companion, but has taken this feedback on board, looking at ways to better accommodate families of wheelchair users in the future.
Yeah, it would just be like treating me like a normal person. I am normal, I just do things in a different way.
As much a part of the crowd as anyone else.
This is awesome, and we need to put a spotlight on this sort of thing. Overseas, they do this really well. Here, we've got some catching up to do.